rise. And you will rise. Rise. Rise.
I don't give a fuck. That's funny for me. If you had godly powers, you would do the same too. I kind of want to put my hand on his head and you're fucking healed. And then have him not get up.
Hey, D. Keith West has multiple sclerosis. How many of them do you have?
Keith?
Oh.
Two counts as multiple. We have other comedians who might have the multiple sclerosis of sclerosis.
If you have all the sclerosis, are you all the sclerosis?
Is it just singular sclerosi? Is that right? God, you know what? This show's just for me and Ian. Fuck you guys. And English. Okay? All right. I was about to say, it's like we could have just put you up on that. You carry your stage around with you.
They don't like you making fun of handicapped folks, though.
Oh, well, this is going to be a long show for them, isn't it? I give a fuck. When Keith West drop kicks me, then I'll stop. Until then, this next comedian definitely has been drop kicked. I didn't see him. Oh, it's fucking all right.
For sure.
This next comedian coming up on stage can only perform at places that are not nearby schools. Everybody makes some noise for Uncle Bunsy.
Uncle Bunsy!
I have to follow. I feel like one of Jerry's kids. I follow Skippy, my wingman, Skippy Sprinkles. He introduces me to all these women. He said, hey, this hot redhead the other night. I didn't get kicked out of that club, though. But this hot redhead, redheads are my kryptonite. I mean, I heard about going to a strip club. One of my ex-wives was an ex-titty dancer and I was warned the other night, I was over at Star Lounge, that every titty dancer here is a prostitute. And there's certain areas you're not supposed to go to. Politics, religion, and anything to do with sex or someone else's sex. Now, and I moved here from Portland, Oregon, June of last year. And because I came from Portland, I can identify as whoever I want to, because that's the rules. And if you have to explain your jokes, they're not funny, but I've got to explain this, because even though this is an LGBTQ community bar here, and the first time I identify myself as a cis male lesbian. And does anyone not know what the term cis means?
Explain it to me.
Okay, because I am Dr. Budsy. I really am a doctor. I was a dental surgeon. So I'm not just some guy that's been smoking weed with all his buddies for 40 years, and I will get to cis, but that's been smoking weed for 40 years, and now he says, this medicine, I've cured. I am a medical marijuana patient, and I have been a medical marijuana patient now, but I am Dr. Budsy. I make medicated barbecue sauce, condiments, and I am going to make medicated condoms because I am back on the dating circuit, so I have to explain about cis. Cis means you were born one way, you're still that way. Look, I almost fell off the stage before explaining this at that time, but you were born one way, you're still that way, and you want to stay that way. It's like a man was born with a penis. He still has his penis, and he wants to keep it. And the same thing for women. They were born with a vagina, and notice I'm using medical terms here because I am Dr. Davis. Nothing about Davis, I'm Budsy, Dr. Budsy. And don't look up on the internet about James Michael Davis, versus the state of Texas. Don't do that. Because I went, someone was talking about pedophilia here. And the thing is, my problem, I went up against one of these Clinton pedophiles. And you know how they are. You don't want to go up against them because they are going to win. Because that's the way that it is. Pedophilia, I think, is a bane on society. Because my ideal relationship is a cis. I want to be with a woman that wants to make me want to be monogamous. And my ideal relationship is a monogamous relationship with one to two one to two hot, cis, bisexual females, preferably between the ages of, say, 22 and 37. And if I had 20 more minutes, I could tell you about Amber Heard and redheads. And because the picture she sent me from Facebook was a redheaded in an Aquaman suit. And she was telling me, anyway, the thing about anyone here on Facebook, if you're on Facebook, I'm Dr. Budsy, and I will be your friend. Because the only friends that I have, I mean, I get all these friend requests from women, you know, that say they want to be friends on Facebook. I say, well, why are you here? And I'm looking for a serious relationship, and I will get off here.
Please.
Well, not really. I am Dr. Budsy, and I'm having a real fun time. Y'all have a good evening, and if you like barbecue, come downtown and eat some barbecue with me.
Yeah, right across from the courthouse. Give it up for Dr. Budsy.
I know you told your friend you're not okay, and tell me what's wrong and why you never said you felt that way.
Cause you're trying to stay Hunter Budsy.
It's so hard for him to stop talking. You ever notice that?
You know, dude, because he, you know what? You need a deaf woman. So I'm kidding. I think I always find it funny. Look, as somebody who's been not to fuck it, toot my own horn, but if you've ever been in like a three-way relationship, they're just exhausting, dude. Fuck that. Like, what's in it for me, you know? Okay, I'm the only fucking freak out here. All right, that's cool. That's fucking cool. Tanner, you know what I'm talking about, right? Fucking high five. Fucking all those homeless bitches. Yep, that's all I'm bringing up the next.